it's me again. We're going to set up the beginning broadcasting here. I just have to share my page so you guys can find me. I do everything around here. And here is Statler City. Wendy is Friday afternoon at 5, starting promptishly. We do this every Friday, and you may be wondering why. Over my shoulder, you can see the famous nomenclature of WBIG-TV. That's because we're about to broadcast Lounge Academy. And I'm trying to find it. Here we are. Here it is. I'm on the WBIG page. Usually, we haven't been using this page since pre-pandemic, but I thought I'd try it tonight. So now I'm going to share it. To my own page. It's very technical. Nobody's here yet, so I'm getting away with this. None of the lounge cadets are here, which is not uncommon. Start coming around now. Sometimes they're a little early, and kind of puts the pressure on me to get set up as I watch them drink. Here we are, I'm slowly making my way. Their connection is a little sluggish. Usually starts out a little sluggish, internet connection wise, just because of the prime time. Okay, let's see if this worked. No. You would think sharing would be easy in 2021. Share me up. I just want to share it. Now, pre-pandemic, this was easy. Well, you know why? Because I'm not me on WBIG-TV on this page. Let's see if I can be me. I gotta be me. I gotta be me. Okay, I'm interacting as my profile. Where the hell did I go? Here we are. This is me. Okay. Share. Share now. I wish they'd let you share this before you press screen, you know? But they don't, and I shouldn't complain because we're broadcasting worldwide for free. By magic. So, why should it make any sense, for that matter? Now, you may not know this, but I'm sitting at a piano in a large historic hotel in downtown Buffalo. Okay, now I'm on my page. Now the home cadets will at least have a fighting chance of knowing I'm here, and should they care, then they can. So the show is underway. Here with my co-host, Bernard. Welcome to the Statler, another great historic night. This is Bernard, he's sitting in the command chair.
He's in charge of the whole state right now. He could throw your ass right out if he wanted to. And he could. I've seen him do it. But it takes a lot. It takes a lot. He doesn't just... There's Dan in the big wigs over there. It's good when they just like don't even see you and they walk right by you. It means you're not on the shit list. That's an industry term. I wouldn't use it as an article of profanity, but it's an actual term, right, Bernard? And we've all been on that list. Proud to say. And here comes Frederick, home favorite. Frederick. Songsmith, how are you, sir?
Bonjour.
Yeah, you are the early bird special.
Well, you're here, that's good. Hi, everybody out there in virtual world, or whatever you call it.
Well, they love Frederick at home because you lead such a... So, you're like to Lounge Academy, what, the star of...
Oh, I like how he goes down. He won't like let me down. He won't let me sit.
He could be the star of Storage Wars. But Lounge Academy got
more like Antiques Roadshow, but
got Frederick's first. And he's good. He's good for pot threats because he has a very active life in the lounge world, and the women just trail behind him.
From your lips to God's ears.
They love singers, and he never stops entertaining.
I love Buffalo.
If anybody could tell me how to make him stop entertaining, we'd all love to know that.
That's why they applaud when I'm done, right? Not because I'm good, because I'm done.
Yeah, that's a start. I'll have to try that. I never finish.
Buffalo's a great place for entertainment and music, and especially Friday night at the Lounge.
Well, thank you, Frederick. Nobody knows Frederick's last name. We don't know if he has one. You have to date him. You have to date him for at least a month before you get.
Venire qui un venerdì dalle cinque fino alle sette c'è sempre Howard Tocarapiano. They can't abandon.
Don't look now, but I think I pissed him off.
He knows.
He's reading my. He's reading my last rites.
I'm inviting everybody who speaks French and Italian to come.
That's great. So he is the most worldly guy I know, and he's also out of this world all at once. That's what we like about it.
Unidentified flying object. But I haven't done those things in years.
Okay. So are you just like winging it tonight?
Just winging it.
And seeing what comes up of the evening?
See what drags in.
All right.
There's always nice people.
Always.
Fun people.
Or else?
And beautiful music and entertainment by now.
Well, thank you. Sometimes there's surprises, like a fire drill.
But I will admit that after this, after how it's completely done, the Curtis Hotel on the rooftop, there's a very nice scene.
Oh, the Italian act?
That's walking distance from
He's
here.
Great.
Yeah.
I've gone to see him.
Gary Petrie.
And his son-in-law,
Mike.
His son-in-law, yeah. That's right. How could I forget? His daughter's beautiful.
Wait.
And I think that's why everybody goes to the rooftop, because his daughter's there, kind of playing hostess.
Like
the way Mary does here.
Okay.
Right? Works the room?
No comment.
They got a great act.
Yeah, they do very well.
The guy's out.
He's once a month at
He's
the,
just a natural.
At the Chandelier Bar as well.
What's his name again for
Gary
everybody?
Gary
Quattrini.
And Michael, his son.
And Michael, his son.
But the music scene in Buffalo is
you can never leave.
Extraordinary. There's so many good musicians and not enough places to play.
So over here at the Statler, we got the Jewish act. And then you go right across the parking lot, you got the Italian act.
Well, I qualify for both. One's a nationality, one's a religion.
Oh, is that right? I didn't.
People say I'm Italian origin.
Whatever you are, Polish, that's what Frederick tells
says
you
I'm
he
Jewish.
Is.
That's apples and oranges.
He's a man for all seasons.
Nationalities of religions.
That's great. That's
my
great.
Mom's Ukrainian Jewish.
Well, this explains
my dad,
a lot.
Italian Catholic.
I've got Ukrainian Jew.
They were
my dad's side.
Yeah. Well, with cousins. My family was kicked out of Ukraine in 1905. The pogrom was the small revolution, but that's another story. That's a long
story. Well, that explains why we that's why we get kicked out of every place we go.
That's why a lot of Jews, diamond cutters, doctors, because you don't need a lot of tools, you just go. Especially now with an electronic piano.
Here's where I flunk out, because I've got so much stuff I can never move.
Historically, that's the case. Maybe it's an anti-Semitic trope, but I don't think so.
See, I think all ethnic stereotypes are dead on.
That's how they become stereotypes.
Yeah.
That's how cliches become cliches, because they're basically right.
Maybe I'm a contrarian because, like, it's not, you know, in to think that way. But, my theory in life, and now we're getting really deep, but Frederick can bring this to you, this place. He can bring you to this philosophical place where you're either going to jump off a cliff or get philosophical.
You could do both. Sometimes.
Now, this
people have done both.
This building's 19 stories. So I better get philosophical.
So I'm not taking a header off this building. Well, I will let Howard hang. We hanging together?
We're killing time here. We're entertaining the home cadets, if there are any.
Thank you, Frederick.
I'm fine.
Thank you.
Appreciate the offer. Always kind.
There he goes, ladies and gentlemen.
Who's with us here tonight?
Anybody?
Well, the show got off to an exciting start.
It always does. Here we go.
When I'm on that remote particular camera, I cannot see Chaz right now because I'm sitting here at master control of Mount Academy at the Statler piano, and Vicky.
Maybe your brothers. Well, if I ever need a kidney, I'll know who to go ask. Thank you, Barbara Fisher. Thank you for
the encouragement and suggestions.
I think it's important to interview the lounge cadets because they're fascinating people. Each one has a story.
Great, Barbara.
So far, just Frederick is here. And I'm here and I'm set up and rolling, which is great. Everything seems to be working. I'll give you a little tour. We've got the VIP table cam. That's this one. And so you'll know, you could call. I had two mics on. Vicky, that makes sense. Here, let me see. I think I could fix that. Okay, that's good, that's good. Here's the one with the feedback, because I had the camera mic on plus the piano mic, and I knew I was taking that chance. Thank you, Vicky. And let me know if the feedback is fixed. It should be. It's only getting the handle on this expansive new equipment set up at WBIG-TV that I spent all summer building. Now I got to spend the rest of my life learning how to use it. It's really a great thing. And anyway, now you're looking at the split screen. This is the hand cam, the keyboard cam. It's kind of fun. And then this one I can move around. I have it on a gimbal. So I'll leave it at the door in case somebody comes in. So I could play cameraman with that one. And then we've got this one, which is kind of shooting the area, as you can see. I can see if anybody's sneaking up on me. And then this is the ultra-wide angle piano bar cam. I try to
situate it
so that it can catch a lot of the action. I think it's achieving that. And then we've got the split cam. And then we've got some other features like good sound now. Thank you, Barbara Fisher. And Barbara Fisher is a big help to the show. And I'd like to give her a shout out with my. There she is right now on the Barbara Fisher shout out feature that we have here at WVIG TV. At my fingertips, I could watch Barbara Fisher photos that we took here whenever I want, just by pressing a button, and so can the home audience. Pretty cool, huh? How do you like that? How do you like them apples? Well, thank you, Selena. You're fabulous too. Oh, well, thanks, Vicki. I'm glad you think it was worth it. It was really quite a project. And yeah, that's a new feature. I made you first on there, Barbara Fisher. I've only got a few people loaded up in there thus far, but all of them, you know, huge Lounge Academy, and you were first, of course. And here comes Frederick. He's got his drink. He's loaded for game. And he's going to situate himself at the VIP table, which is like kind of like ice fishing for. Do I have? Hang on, I got to make sure I got audio meter here. Where's my audio meter? I don't see my audio meter. Okay, we don't need that. Hide. Okay, my meter was hiding behind another dock. All in all, we're getting a handle on this thing. And there's Frederick right there. You can see he's constantly scanning his other opportunities on his radar screen. Most people, he has an actual radar app on his phone. It's a lounge radar. And it's in every language. So he can see what's going on. Ladies and gentlemen, here comes some VIPs, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody at home, stand up and applause for Brenda.
Here,
Mary,
next to
and George, George Kunz, of course.
Did you bicycle down there?
No.
Mary's brother, my brother-in-law. How are you, sir?
Hey, Howard, how are you?
I'm good.
Warm day out, but cool inside
here. It is, you know, and I just love the summer in this.
We're going to go upstairs and be right back.
Beautiful. You're going to powder your nose.
No, we're going to get a drink.
All right. Howard, have you started?
We're streaming. That was the first note. I didn't play a note until you walked in.
Hey, brother. How are you? Good to see my friend.
Ladies and gentlemen, I got the mics over here, but I'm talking to you guys over there. I did, here's another surprise. Achievement for tonight is I brought the Lounge Academy bell. So we've got it in case people start getting unruly, I've got the bell. I will now turn on and adjust the microphone. Oops, I got two mics open. We don't want that. I gotta knock that stuff off. Okay, here we go. Probably had echo. Now we don't. I think I'll keep this trained on the entrance, because it's exciting as the celebrities walk in. Well, that'd be awesome. Maybe she'll do that dance she did. She did that dancing video, and she did a good job. Yeah, when she was bartending. Audrey Clark. Glad I didn't miss Audrey Clark. Nice to see you, Audrey. We're doing great. We are having fun. Glad to see you're having fun along with us. Another state. Audrey is the founding president of the Jackie Jocko Fan Club. I think that was founded in the 1950s. What year was that founded, Audrey? By you and her fabulous girlfriends. I saw the photo albums, George, and I'm telling you what. It was a great, great group of fans, Jocko had. Still has them. Yeah, isn't that nice?
Yeah.
Nice to see you.
the surprises we have tonight. Ryan was just referring to it. This is called a teaser, ladies and gentlemen. And we received a mysterious package a day or two ago back at the mansion, the old house downtown. This is it. I got the wrong. That's a real teaser. And let's catch the girls coming back with their drinks here. But they're going to sit at the piano. Connor's here, ladies and gentlemen. Nice to see you, sir. Connor's a genius. I collect geniuses. I don't marry them all, but Connor's one of them, I'll tell you. No, he's modest. That's a good trait. Genius. Okay, back to the presentation here. We got this mysterious package in the mail. It's mysterious because I wasn't expecting it. I don't recognize the name on the current address, although I can't really, it's Kelly somebody. I can't really make out the spelling of the last name. I'm no one to speak about penmanship because nobody could read my writing either, and mine's worse, much worse than this. But it's from Jamestown, New York. And now, occasionally, we get unsolicited manuscripts at WBIG-TV. Sometimes they're addressed to our publishing department, which is called New York Publishing. So those are always exciting to get because we without opening them, we got a pretty good idea that they're book manuscripts, unsolicited. Nonetheless, but they're addressed to publishing, but this is just 153 Delaware Avenue, which is a familiar address that we get something, but it doesn't have a company name or a person's name on it. So when we get these packages, we leave them for Ryan, who's president of WBIG-TV. And I leave them on his desk. He opens them up. We're going to open that on the show tonight and see what it is. Maybe I didn't put enough out there. If we need more, Zach, pull a couple out of the tip jar. I use them as coasters. I guess that's the only one we got. I wiped it off after each use. Because of the high gloss, it's easy to
piano black.
Oh, I see.
And all that means is that it constantly looks dirty.
Yeah.
Unless you wipe it every time you're in your car, and even then it still looks dirty. Because it accumulates.
Kind of like a smartphone.
Yeah.
It's exactly like that. I am finally the package of Mr. What do you guys think is in that package?
Where's it
from? Jamestown.
Could be full of cash.
Not much.
Could be a tip.
It's like $1,000
bills. It could be ounce caps.
It suggests to your place in Buffalo.
What about it?
Buffalo. B-U-F-F-L-O.
Oh, I did not notice that. Yeah, Buffalo, they left out a letter. Maybe it's from their children's book.
Nope, it's not from the same guy as before. He's like an adult now. He has kids.
Well, do you think we should open the mysterious package right now?
Well, I don't know if I can contain my excitement, but if you think it would be better another time...
No, let's do it now before... The room fills up anymore.
Now, this is from Kelly Fenty? Maybe related to Rihanna.
Yeah, I wasn't able to make out the entire name.
And maybe it's Fenty? Or, I don't know. Kelly, somebody in Jamestown.
It looks like something like 8.5 by 11-inch. Would be in this, right?
Well, it feels like paper, definitely.
Think it's our MacBook manuscript?
8.5 by 11, yeah. Because
it's not very thick.
No.
It could be what they now call low content book.
I hope there's no anthrax in here.
Well, that's another reason why we have Ryan open these.
This doesn't have one of those easy open tabs on it.
Tearing it open.
He's peering inside. Oh.
Of the mysterious package, which is now open.
It looks like.
I think this might not be.
It's a manuscript.
It is a manuscript.
And it has a handwritten cover letter.
With a handwritten cover letter. I'm repeating what he's saying in case. In case anybody needs that.
Shall I read it aloud?
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Nice to see you all.
And that's an issue. Some honor races. To the Corset administration, for that is for George, Mary, Brenda, Frederick.
I wonder how people find us.
I don't know, because I never return their calls. That only makes them want us more.
Wow, this is... I can't wait to read this.
So what it's a book.
Hi, my name is Kelly Fenty. I wrote this book. Would really like to get it published.
Here, hang on, I'm going to switch mics for you so that we can all hear you.
Shall I start over?
Yeah, he's reading the manuscript.
Or should I redact the names?
Well, wow, this is reality TV.
Hi, my name is Kelly Fenty. I wrote this book. Would really like to get it published. This is my first time doing anything like this. My number is redacted. Please feel free to call me with any questions or concerns. Thank you.
And put you back to the piano.
Plus a box of camera, too. Frederick knows his stuff.
And the name of the book is Always and Forever.
Always and Forever.
Turn it over. Like this?
You're preserving.
Oh. I didn't. It's about someone named Kate. who is 21 years old and lives in New York City.
I see. Well, why don't we do the standard procedure, and you could you could delve into that, and then we'll pick up on it next time with whatever we decide to make of this mysterious package we received this week in the mail. It's an unsolicited book manuscript.
This is going to be very, very good.
The audience does not seem to be. They seem incredulous in this whole situation, which they probably think we just set it up, but it's reality. Even Zach's reading it.
We've had a variety of manuscripts sent to us through the years, everything from a children's book to a Vietnamese tome to.
That was quite a work, too.
Yeah.
All right, well, Ryan's going to. We're going to revisit this once we have a chance to digest this, to see what we think of it and what its relevance is.
This envelope
to us.
This envelope is a very effective coaster. My drink
is already useful as a coaster.
Bleeding through these.
That's a good sign. This book is immediately useful. Even if we don't. Publish books.
We may just have to publish this one.
Sometimes it makes us want to jump into the publishing business.
Dying to know.
We're kind of like an impromptu Shark Tank for unsolicited book manuscripts.
Yeah,
we open them up and everybody kind of has an opinion on it. But we've got some, pretty much everybody here has a great literary mind.
And they all seem extremely interested.
I think lots of times they feel threatened by these too. Sometimes they're really intense.
Thank you.
Take a chance on your memories. part of the evening where everybody's sober.
Thank you. Well, tell you, it's on.
I don't ask a question unless I already know the answer. Because I've been married for 15 years. Cheese and mead board. So maybe they provide a beverage with it? Here.
Frederick, I submit this into evidence.
She walked right into that one. Excitements that, you know. I'll be right back.
Oh, you're right? Long break.
Well, thank you. I'm glad it seemed long.
Thanks,
everybody. Thank you.
Synchronization.
Thank you. Yes, David.
I'm going to interrupt your broadcast. Are you on the live?
Yeah, we're on.
Hello, everyone. How do I look?
You now have an alibi.
How's the hair?
The hair is awesome.
I'm giving you a present.
Oh, well, thank you. Oh, no
book. A cartoon book.
It's a Rolls Royce, though.
Oh, yeah. You need to work carefully. There you go. That's
thank
fine.
You.
I want to sign it.
Yeah, I don't have a tiny. Well, maybe one will turn up.
Thank you.
here looking for David.
Thank you.
not the same. I'm afraid the masquerade.
That was great.
Oh, thanks.
I do like that song.
I was thinking, maybe we could turn this into a play.
Really?
Yeah.
It's, wow, well, we know people that know how to do that. That's for sure.
I'm feeling inspired. Do you think we could turn that into a play? I think it would work well as a play. Oh no, how about a movie? Yes, a movie.
8mm. We won't spare any expense. Super 8.
It could be our first film.
Then I remember your mind is
Stuff like that, I would think.
heavy, heavy crime. Hears a lot of stories and sees a lot of things. You can keep his perspective, that's his job. Turning these things into words and digging into the stories and doing the research, they retain it all. And they just become, you know, like you just can't step into that job, you know. I've seen the young guys there. Thank you. sponsored by Connor. My genius friend Connor's talking to Bernard, my co-worker. It's like the mayor is shaking everybody's hand. Connor knows everybody in the place. Everyone wants a piece of Connor. Even though he's going someplace.
I gotta go see Eddie.
He's going to see Eddie. He's probably going for a fish ride.
I'm coming back up in a second. I
got a
book for you guys.
Oh, great, great. He's coming back, ladies. Stand by. Connor's coming. We'll be right back. He is a genius. Pretty evident as soon as you start talking to him. Give a shout out to President
WBIG-TV. Ryan Lysars. This little special presentation we put together about Ryan Lysars being broadcast right now as I speak. There he is with Mary holding up. There's Mike Beato. He's just out. There's Zach and Brian. There he is. There's Zach again. We're watching a presentation, a multimedia presentation.
Thank you.
In the wrong place. Here we go. Now you can really hear me.
Ooh, why aren't we there now?
Noisy, you can come next Friday. We're here every Friday from 5 to 7 plus. To 7 whenever. Until the audience takes its last pass. I finish every one of them off.
Oh,
I thought I had it, but I don't see it. Nancy with the Laughing Face by Jimmy Van Heusen and lyrics by Phil Silvers, which he didn't write a lot of lyrics.
He wrote that one. Night and day, you are the one, only you beneath the stars, under the sun, near to me or far, no matter, darling, where you are, I think. They had politics back then too. I don't think things changed much. We can just insult each other faster now with the technology, right? From the island of Manhattan to the coast of gold, from north to south, from east to west, by the love I love the best. You're the dream girl of the sweetest story ever told. A dream I've sought both night and day. Very obviously you.
Yeah.
cover? Gershwin and Gershwin of the I Sing.
That first went on for a little bit, too.
Like entertaining an all show business audience like we have here tonight, like we have with the home cadets, like Liza, because you understand the pain of the creative process. Entertainers have a sensitivity. Telethon. Songs that they always play on a telethon for some reason.
Thank you. young on such a night like this. Want to leave out any real life characters. Script. Home. He's gonna take up the whole thing so that we get separated.
I was just using it for a
mystery envelope. We got an unsolicited manuscript in the mail, and I did not. We opened it here on the show earlier. This is a new one. Yeah, it just came, and Ryan opened it. And this one was particularly mysterious because.
They mailed it to the WBIG-TV address on in downtown Delaware Avenue, 153 Delaware, 14202. But it did not have, like, to say to, you know, a pension publishing company. How are you tonight, sir? Great work tonight. We appreciate it. It's keeping our all our patrons drunk.
Hey, Mary. My brother.
He'd have to put his touch on it.
I know.
I mean, he's that kind of guy.
Okay, if it was some kind of jazz thing I was playing, something like that. But what could be better than to have someone wanting to hear something and then you could give them that pleasure?
But
I don't think he got it. I don't think he understood what made that song so beautiful.
No, but when Jacko said to me, you know, we were just talking, and there was that group behind us.
Oh, yeah.
And he said, And then I started thinking, well, I said, you know, I bet you that's, I think, I just read about that guy. He's the guy from Seattle, America. Mm. And then it all came together.
Yeah.
And I said, and I came up with, he wrote a bunch of songs, as you know.
Yeah.
I said, he wrote Mona Lisa. Jacko went into it like a maestro.
Yes. Oh.
And that put those guys together like you've never seen it.
Oh, what a nice thing.
I mean, Hollywood writers couldn't time it any better.
No, and to be paid tribute to like that, a testament honored like that, that was very cool. I'm glad that Jacko heard about that. I told you he did that for Leonard Canario.
I know that.
That was not something normal. I mean, who in the world? It's been a long time.
Nobody knew who he was.
Yeah. No, he's been completely forgotten. And but Jacko was able to get it together and knew and was able to welcome him like that. And I will never forget him.
Isn't that nice?
Yeah. I mean, just that day he got to feel something he hadn't felt in years. I mean, so somebody, and I think that must have been the support of that. People are ignorant, they don't know.
After he met him, like that. He used to get a letter from every 10 days.
Yes, I got a couple letters from him.
He was that
George
kind of guy.
George had a correspondence going. George was writing to him.
Well, you told me that,
yeah.
But you know, some of those guys like him, I mean, he's been around forever. He's classy as all get out.
Yeah. I did write about him in the paper, too, though, and he got a kick out of that. That's why he wrote to me, so I did do something. I wrote about him, about how he was and how wonderful it was to see him. Yeah, and what Jacko was saying. I did write something.
No, but those two guys, they bonded almost.
You heard Jacko go to Maria, but he's very big guy.
You want me to, Rich Sellers wants me to, as a, I never got a request to finish a song before. go back and finish.
I'm not used to drinking white wine. I miss red wine.
Oh, all right.
I like that.
I didn't notice, but I know you drink
it. My keto diet.
Was that part of your diet?
Yeah, the white wine's a little bit better than red wine. But I'll be going back once I lose.
Well, here's another one. Richard, how about this?
You still at it?
We'll finish Misty by playing another one that starts with an M.
That's a good diet. You eat a lot of meat.
So hard to lose weight.
Well, you just mark the time, and every week the scales down a little bit more.
Oh, maybe
while you're
on the
but it's an easy diet to
do. Oh, all right.
You eat a lot of meat and a lot of fat. I like that.
I can do that.
So I can't have half and half in my coffee, but I can have heavy cream in my coffee. I love the heavy cream. I'm getting a load of it. Heavy cream. And I eat
heavy cream's better than half and half?
Yes, according to the keto diet. Because the half and half has carbs and it spikes your insulin. But the heavy cream.
I really prefer half and half over milk anyway.
Yes, well, you love it. You have the heavy cream. And then you do butter. You're allowed to eat something low fat like shrimp. Shrimp is kind of low fat, but you have to dip it in melted butter because you're supposed to get the fat.
I'd be a willing.
You fat and you're not eating between meals.
Here you go, Richard. Here's the substitute song. More I see you.
So I feel good. And every week, yeah, I could be doing it better.
Sports writer primarily for the Courier.
Oh, okay.
George loved it. But anyway, I forgot what I was going to tell you about.
Yeah, I'm surprised. I wonder where Bob was tonight for your Bob.
Oh, yeah, he would have.
Yeah, we'll have to ask him about it.
He probably had coffee with him.
Hello. Well, what Bob told me was, you would have fitted well in the Courier, and I took that as such a compliment.
Sure,
you
know, yeah.
This is a part of the night I particularly love. It's 3 in the morning. Everybody's
just
drunk. The room's full of smoke.
Reading, I read them both.
Yeah.
The Courier is a better paper.
That's interesting because I was a kid when it rolled and
I love sports.
Yes, yeah, so I love sports.
Yeah.
The news had a good sports.
They knew how to play catch up. I saw the Courier.
I don't mind anymore because I'm going.
How's the audio for you, Nick? I've got it set up so that you can hear the musicology of Mary and Paul. Switched over to their mic. So you're actually hearing me on their mic.
I don't know if I never read them.
But you're able to hear them about it.
So.
See, that's what being my friend.
But I love the sports.
Let me know how the mix it is. I'll be tired of
you. Yeah, she wrote the memoirs of Lyndon Johnson.
Yeah, okay. And
when stars grow tired.
Okay, yeah, people have asked
me.
But one step beyond that was she was a huge baseball fan.
When I'm tired.
I mean, she's the same age as I was. And she wrote a book called Wiggle Next Year, which was
a book of that.
They were always.
This I know is true.
Her childhood. Her father made her a book.
When winds grow tired.
She did the same thing. Fight for the morning.
Box
Squeezed every audience member. Well, sure.
Sure. Well, you're my favorite audience. Is there anything special you came hoping to hear tonight? Well, we did miss Steve. Okay. This goes out by request to the Buffalo News music critic, Emeritus, ex officio, Emerita, ex officio. Oh, really? Oh, great, great idea. Oh, did they? Well, the world needs you.
Anyway, you there,
what am I playing again? Oh, yeah. Mary likes this song because she molded me from a lump of clay into this sharpened jewel. We're having a very romantic effect on everybody in the building tonight, which is why we're here, right, Bernard? Bernard does not have a date here. He's working solo. He's working solo tonight. That's how he rolls when he's working. But that doesn't mean that the romantic envelope these songs put you into is any different, no matter what you're doing or who you're not with. Even more so when you're not with that person. What half these songs were written for. Change me. I try to change me.
He knows how to make a vodka and soda. Oh, he's there now. Or is he working that room?
He wasn't there.
He might be working the party. In their personal life that we can exploit for a good television. Because that's why we're here, doing Reality Piano Bar. That's the premise.
And I have to read
Speaking of
Fiction. I have to read Ulysses.
That's a tome. You have to reread Ulysses.
And I have to read it out loud to myself because Connor, I promised Connor I would.
Did he write Ulysses?
No, James Joyce did, kind of likes it.
He wants you to read it out loud for some reason?
Well, he said you only really understand it if you read it out loud, because James Joyce said that to understand his writing, you had to read it out loud.
Oh.
So I'm going to try to do that.
What
and
if
see
you're
where
reading,
it takes
you just
me.
Move your lips? Does that count?
Well, it might get under my fingers a little bit, because he is a wonderful writer, and they have the manuscript of Ulysses at UB.
Well, I'm looking forward to hearing you read it.
I know, I've never read it. I read Portrait of the Artist, but I never read it.
Maybe you should read the whole book right now on the show. How long
would
it take?
Just the introduction.
How many hours would it take to read that?
I don't know, but I wonder if there's any... But the introduction alone, oh no, what am I doing? It goes on to like 50 pages. This is all the introduction, right? Ulysses.
Uh-oh, we're losing a camp.
Stately plump Buck Mulligan came from the stairhead.
Jumping into action with my emergency battery because I'm a professional. Oops, I think we lost it, yeah? Here we go. You get it back? No. His camera back. Otherwise, she's frozen in place. There she goes. She's moving again. Yeah, I saw her blink. It's working. Hey, well, we had a great time, Mary, tonight.
It was a really fun night.
It's fun. We get different. As has always been the case for years, whether at the mansion or here at the Statler, on the Lounge Academy show, we never know really who's gonna be there.
We never have any idea.
Or how many. And it's a constant rotation of about 200 regulars. You know, some.
Is it that many?
I think we made a list of everybody.
We should make a list.
Yeah, I think it would be around 200 people.
Yeah.
And now some of them come every like 3 years. You know, and then others, they come at all different frequencies. Some almost every week.
Yeah.
And others come by every month or two or three or a couple times a year.
Yeah.
You know? And they're each on their own schedules. Their own Lounge Academy rhythm. You know, it seems so peaceful here, but it's like we're actually picnicking on the side of a live volcano because there's 175 people plus, 175 people drinking behind the marble wall, behind me, in the huge Statler Golden Ballroom, at a wonderful wedding.
Yes.
We're having dinner.
That's right. They're
drinking,
there.
Doing all the things you do at a wedding. And this place is so big and insulated that you feel Frederick's there. What have you done with Brenda? Is this going to be like that news story? This could be a really good one for reality piano bar. Brenda disappeared. Brenda's back. Fred's back. Well, maybe we should start packing it in. What do you think?
Okay, yeah. I think it's probably...
Thank you, Barbara Fisher. Always appreciate Barbara Fisher tuning in, and she's such a great Lounge Cadet, whether she's on this side of the camera or the other side of the camera. And she's building a palace. I'm really impressed with Barbara Fisher's architectural skills.
Yeah,
she
put
some pictures up of parts of her new place that's being completed. And she could have a business doing it.
Yeah,
you know, I'm truly impressed. I had no idea she could do that. It's really, really something. Good job, Robert. I might hire your firm when I'm ready for some design work. Design and decorating. Actual. Architectural design and the elements of the room. Well, it looks like Mary's ready for me to start packing in. I could read her like a cheap watch. So we'll say goodnight. Goodnight, Barbara Fisher. Goodnight, everybody. Get a good guest book to pass around. That's a great idea.
Oh, a guest book is a good idea.
And then they put comments. She said
it's, really
you pass
idea.
It around. She had one from the 50s of her parents.
Oh.
Said it's fun to see the comments of the guests.
Oh, that's a good idea.
That's
yeah,
a
we'll
fantastic
pass it around.
Idea.
That's a great idea.
We're going to do it.
I'll put it on Zazzle. I'll get one.
Okay. We'll get one this week.
Yeah.
At least
I'll make one.
Yeah. That's a great done, Barbara Fisher.
That's a great idea.
Here she goes again.
The guest book, yeah. Where we keep it.
She is a designer, that's why. I knew it. See, I could tell.
Yeah, it'd be a nice record of how things go from week to week, too.
That's just a great idea. I love it. I wish I would have started that 10 years ago.
Yeah, we could have had it today. The guest book goes around. Yeah, just pass it around.
Well, good night, everybody. We'll do this all again in 7 days. 7 days minus a couple of hours. The time is going on 8 o'clock. So we'll just put in a little extra time for you.
whether the audience wants us to or not.
A couple weeks ago, they wouldn't stop. That's
right.
That was really great. All right, Clever.
Frederick, so your turn. Folks stop at 7.
He returns.
Well, we 7 plus.
No, it's a plus plus. I came back because I left my credit card. I didn't close out my bill.
Oh my gosh.
Why don't you join us at the Curtis on the rooftop? Gary's singing there.
Oh, I love him. Well, I got to pack up all my stuff. So
pack up all my stuff and go. There I go. Bye-bye, music. Come on, let's go.
See that Frederick? He's always ready to. He's always. He's mad. He left Brenda on the rooftop. It's a way to roll. All right. Well, good night, everybody. Have a great, great time. Thank you. Thanks, everybody. And we'll look forward to seeing you all again next week. I will now take the finger that can create music or stop music. And I will now press end. I will now end the live stream. Let me do this the safe way so I don't accidentally cut off the end of the show. It is possible to do that. Stop streaming. Good night, everybody.